Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. It's time for another Fishing Planet video. Live and unedited, make no mistake. Be it bluegill, bass, muskie, or splake. We don't fish the clock here, baby. We fish the lake. Okay, guys and girls. Girls and guys. This is something I wanted to share with you here. Today we are up in Canada, and we are fishing from a kayak. Now, one of the things about fishing from the boat, and you do want to kind of leave your anchor up, is the fish will actually pull you along. So we use our anchor to stop us, but the fish will actually pull you along, and it kind of saves some of the wear and tear on your gear. This is especially good if, you're kind of a lower level and you're fishing in this lake and you find that your gear's getting torn up. But one of the other things that I want to talk about with this is there is actually a bait coins reward. And I think, don't quote me on this, but I think you get some fishing line too. For the fish, if they cause you to lose your balance and flip you over. So, here we go. Like I said, the fish will actually pull you along. So, let's see if we can get one and show you kind of how that works. Alright, we have our fishing rod, we have our anchor up. And we are ready to cast. Let's see if we can get one hooked here. There we go. Yeah, see how he kind of pulls us along? Now, kind of easy to lose your tension on your line, so you gotta pay attention to what you're doing. But there you go. Trophy Lake Trout. First fish of the day. But yeah, you kind of let them pull you along. This will save the wear and tear on your gear. And once again, like I said, we can allow those fish to flip us over from time to time. Oh, come on, boat. Go that way. Yes, that way. And here you have it, folks. This is why I'm buying a bass boat. I'm not very good on paddling a canoe. I think it's probably because there's some ice behind me or something. I don't know why it don't want to. So we get set up, drop our anchor to get us stopped and stabilized. Get out our rod, throw it out there, look at that, not doing very good at casting this morning. Throw it out there. What the hell, Bip Cantrell? Here we go. Maybe I can keep it in the water this time instead of put it on the pier. Alright, like I said, we make our cast. If we can't talk our fish into biting. There he is. Huh? Got the bite, just didn't get the hook. Okay, let's try that one more time. Looks like Gary just ain't having no part of that. Let's try that fishy out there, see what he's got to say this morning. Plus it's sideways, so maybe we can get that tip over. Well, we caught some weeds, which is very common here in White Moose Lake. But okay, so let's just pick a random cast anywhere in between these two spots. Ah, there he is. There he is. Let's see if we can get him to flip us over. Yeah, there he is. Let's see if we can get him to turn us over. Nope. No flip today. But you get the general idea, you know. Like I said, it puts a lot less tension on your line. You see the fish come in a great deal faster. You know, if you don't really have a strong setup and you find that you're, you know, kind of beat your equipment up here, and you want to kind of stay a little bit longer, that is a technique you can use. Like I said, I see people fish from the boats, and they tend. Why this boat has no control? This is the top end boat, ladies and gentlemen. Look, this thing's supposed to do 7 mile an hour. That's the fastest canoe you can buy. Look at that. See it? 7 mile an hour. That's great in a straight line. Damn thing won't turn for nothing. I can head to where I'm going real quick, but I can never park on the shore.